Hey guys, welcome back to our channel. To those students who have started their studies this academic year, hope you had a great week. I know those students who are attending or taking their classes online, I know this is not how you imagined your abroad education to be. But don't worry guys, the whole world is going through it, we will get through it and everything will be alright at the end. So okay, moving on. Today's video is most requested topic by our audience. It is how to apply for housing allowance. So after the introduction, Harshil will walk you through all the necessary steps which are required to apply for a housing allowance. But before moving on, please subscribe to our channel if you haven't already. So guys, before moving on, let me tell you, the whole housing allowance video is two-part video. This is the first part in which we will walk you through all the important steps, and the second part will be around eligibility and all the important details revolving around the housing allowance. Please keep in mind, in this first part of the recording, the first one, we will walk you through the official Dutch government portal. But in that, on that portal, you will not get to see all the details because we have already applied for housing allowance last year. And the second portal of the same recording, you will get to see all the details and we will walk you through field by field which you need to fill when applying for housing allowance. So yeah, let's continue.
Welcome to our channel and you heard the introduction, but this time it is a very nice screen record to take you guys through the step-by-step process of how you can apply your housing allowance. So of course we'll provide the link for you in the description box, but as you can see, I'm trying to first take you to the login page. So this is the TuSLagen login, and this is where I go to apply. This is a government website, and I always open these websites on Chrome because it gives me easy translation options. So here all the Dutch is automatically converted into English. Now, DigiID is something which you need to log into your all government portals. So we will talk about DigiID in some of our other videos, but please remember that without DigiID you cannot log in. So I have a DigiID and I will log in using that. And this is my username, and okay, so this is the page that comes up when you log in to the DigiID. Now this is of course all in Dutch, so please translate it into English, and you go to my household here. And as you can see, in my household, since the rental lease is on my name, so I am the primary person here, and Saurabh lives with me, so this is his mansion and we both live here. Now, actually, the thing is, we have already filed for our housing allowance. But since I want to show you guys, what I can do is, I'll take another option. So I'll just say that my rent changes. So I'll just give them a date from which my rent has changed. So for you guys who are new here, put in your lease date, and I'll say that yes, this is the address for which I want to change my rent. And in your rental lease, you will find these basic costs. So there will be a basic rent, there will be energy cost, there will be cleaning cost, there will be caretaker cost, and then there will be cost of service and recreation areas per month. People who live in movable caravans, this is the rent for caravan site per month. So this is not the case with us. So what I'll do is, I'll fill out some details for you over here. So I'm typing 6, 7 is my basic rent, let's say, and this is 10 euros because this is the usually range of these costs per month, and this is this much and this is this much. And when I type here next one, I'll just enter 0 here because it's 0 for us. I'll type here next, and something went wrong. Maybe this is the problem. So this should be lesser. So I'll just type 600. Okay, so this is just a confirmation. I'm continuing this. And now it is asking me that this is the summary of all the costs that I have entered. And it is asking me if this is the final cost and if I want to agree and send this. Now in your case, please agree and send this. In my case, I'm not doing this because I have already applied for housing allowance. Now I will show you where you can see the decision of Dutch government, whether they will provide you the allowance or not. So once you agree and send, once you fill in all the details, go to my decisions. Here you will see all the decisions that have been taken in your name. So for example, in 2019, if I show you, they gave us zero healthcare allowance because we did not have Dutch health insurance. We had private health insurance. So if you open these links, you can see that this is zero. We did not get any healthcare allowance because we did not have any Dutch allowance. But if you see the rental allowance here, you'll see that yes, we did get rental allowance. We get 314 euros of rental allowance per month. Now you can see these fields here are blank because we came in after on 15th August and our rental allowance started from 1st September, and that's why these fields are blank. So before you guys apply for the rental allowance, all of these fields will be blank for you. And if the decision is yes from the Dutch government, you will see how much rental allowance you will get here. And yeah, that is that. And you can do more things. So for example, if just like I showed you, if you are moving somewhere, then you can use this option. If your rent changes, then you can do this option. And if you getting married, or if you're shifting with someone else, and if you are trying to so for example, me and Saurabh, we live together, and say Saurabh decides to move into another house, then I will choose this option to notify the authorities. So this my household page basically is the page where you can make all the changes and notify the Dutch government. This was a very short procedure, and of course things are not easy. So when I was first applying for housing allowance, I had to fill in a lot of details. So I'll take you to another website. This is another website, housingallowance.nl. Here you will get a clear cut picture of how many details you have to fill. So for example, if I go to free calculation, this is a very, very authentic website. So here is actually the amount of details that you have to fill in. So you know what, let's fill it together. So let's say that for which year do you want to apply change of stop? So I'll say 2020. Do you want to apply alter? So I want to apply for a housing allowance. I'll enter my birth date here. I'll apply my year, and then I'll apply this, and then I'll apply the switch it to 2019. 2020 itself. Let's say I want to apply from January. No, I don't have Dutch nationality. I have non-EU nationality. And do you have Dutch? Yes, I do have Dutch residence permit. Okay, so it will now ask me, are you registered with the municipality at the address? Yes, I am. Do you or your partner receive other allowances like healthcare, childcare, or child budget? No, we don't. Here, to be entitled to Dutch, so these are the actual questions which you will be filling in the Toeslagen website. But since I have already filled my details there, this is a replica of the form, and these are the exact details that you have to fill there. So so they say that to be entitled to Dutch housing allowance, you must have independent housing. Do you meet all of the following conditions? So we are living in so all of these conditions, they do apply to us. So I'll type yes. Are you married, or you have a registered partnership? I'll say no. Do you have a roommate? Yes, because me and Saurabh, we live together. What is the birth date of your roommate? And now I'll here type Saurabh's birth details, and he's 91. And then BSN number, this is again, we have talked about, this is called burger service number. This is a Dutch, it's like your social security number, which is unique to every individual. So right now I'll just type a dummy BSN. Income for now, let's say our income is zero. What is the gross, even his income is, let's say, zero. Does the value of your worldwide assets, so no, we do not have any assets which will amount to 42,660 euros, so I'll say no. And then again the same details that we filled here, so I'll say 600 here, let's say 12 here, 12 here, 12 here, 12 here. So this is according to them, this is my total. Now I'll calculate. Now see here, this is the exact thing. So now they are asking me for my initials. So my initials is HP, and but as you can see, I am entitled, I'm sorry, as you can see, I am entitled to 321 euros per month. And now it's just a matter of rest of the details. So I enter my name and surname here, I enter my address here, postal code and city where me and Saurabh we live in. This is my BSN that they are asking for, my telephone number, my Dutch bank account, and then email addresses where they can contact you. Then here I will fill in Saurabh's details, his BSN, his birth dates, and then I'll upload my rental contract, I'll upload my ID and password, and then I'll click these boxes and then I'll submit. And then it will, so this is the exact replica of the housing allowance form that all of you need to fill if you want to receive a housing allowance in Netherlands. I really hope that the video, the screen record was detailed enough for you guys. And yeah, meet you outside. Bye guys.
I know guys, you have so many questions in your mind. Please write all of them in the comment box so that we can address each one of them in our second part of the video. Until then, please subscribe to our channel and share our videos with all of your friends. So until next time guys, bye.